Hello and welcome to another episode of GDL-IL, GDL-Israel. Today we're going to do some things. We'll start with checking out how we could run Node.js on Google infrastructure, on Google Cloud. And we'll use, of course, Compute Engine to do that. And later, we'll see how easy it is to use Node.js in order to run things like fetching data from other sources on the web. It might be another API, and in our case, I took a different set of APIs, not directly Google ones, just to show you the power of getting information from any open API that you have out there, and then using Google Sheets in order to upload this API, this data, and then later on, of course, using it and leverage it inside Google Sheet. The nice thing, or the nice theme that is connecting all the dots in this episode will be JavaScript. And we have JavaScript on the server side, and of course, we'll use Node.js to execute it. And then we have JavaScript as the scripting language of Google Docs and Google Apps that allows you to do clever, sophisticated things on the information, on the data that you already fetched and put in your Google Sheets, in our case. So without further ado, let me just share my screen with you. And maybe today I'll just share my old desktop so I could jump quickly. Or maybe it would be wiser. I'll just try to go through this little blog post that just summarizes all the things that we are going to touch on. The blog post is live as 10 minutes ago, so feel free to go and check it out. And of course, I'll put links to this blog post on the footnotes of this show on developer.google.com site. So feel free, you don't need to write anything. basically, what we're going to show here is the ability to go, and in this case, I just choose Yahoo Finance API, just because it that I got lots of questions on how to use it and leverage it from inside Google Sheets. And here in the example, you basically Yahoo allows you to do things like get a certain URL. Let me make all the fonts much larger. And then if you're putting here, I put Netflix, but you could put any ticker. And after you put a ticker, you have a set of, let's say, parameters, or it's more crypting keys that will fetch the right information that you want. And once you are clicking on it, basically you're downloading a CSV file that you can later on work with it. In our case, we want to do something nicer, and basically to take even farther this approach of getting data, getting information, and then putting it into good work, into good usage inside Google Sheets. So what I did here is, after you're installing Node.js, and if you remember correctly, I have an episode in the past here on this how to install Node.js on Compute Engine in less than 5 minutes. So just go search it and do that. That's the first step that you need to do. But after you're installing Node.js, basically you just need those three packages. And luckily for us, the community around Node.js is holding a very large sets of libraries and frameworks and abilities, basically already made wheels for us, so we don't need to reinvent the wheels again. And in this case, I just choose those three libraries. One is the request model that just lets you work easily with URLs. Basically, we're using a very easy way of fetching the information with a GET request, but once you're installing it, basically you have all the different possibility of do authentication, of doing auth, post, and all the good things that you'll want to do later on. So it's a good thing to have right at the beginning of a new project that is going to do something interesting with API that is being fetched over HTTP. Then I put Cheerio. it's a cool name. And for us, it's basically jQuery on the server side. So the ability to work with the dollar sign that we all loved, and just to be able to have these CSS selectors to get the right piece of information from this or that location in the DOM, very easy to do. So that's why I use this one. And last but not least, just to make our life easy when we're going to integrate and upload and edit and update our information, let's just leverage, again, already built module that letting us just work with Google spreadsheets. After we having those three little pieces of code in place, our code will be really, really short. So in these three lines, we're just fetching the models so we could work with them later. And then, of course, we have those few parameters that we want to keep as global to our script. I highly recommend you to remove them as in line 19 is written here, not black on white, but clearly enough. You want to remove them from the global scope. In this specific simple case, I just left it there, but probably the first thing that I'll do tomorrow morning will be just to remove them from the global scope. Make sure that I'm encapsulating them inside an object, so when this project will get bigger and bigger and not just live as a gist, we'll be able to have all the best practices of software development, and we won't fall quickly. So the basic constant here are just the ticker, and probably it will be wiser just to put it as a variable so that the user will enter from the script itself. Later on, just the endpoint, and in your case, it might be Google Cloud endpoint. It might be any other API that letting you just fetch information over HTTP. Or HTTPS, and then just some two actually arrays that letting us have the keys or mainly the metadata on the data that we're going to fetch and the details themselves. Then we have functions that we're using, sheet ready, we'll touch on it later, and in this one basically we're just calling the request, so after we fetching the URL. Here you can see that first and foremost I just want to see that everything came back correctly with status code of 200. If it's 400 or 500 or other things, I want probably to just notify the user. And in this case, I just loading into Cheerio the body, and then nicely enough, I have this dollar sign that I could work with. And in this case, I'm just choosing one table that containing all the information, and then I'm getting all the TDs in this table into my array, the keys. And I'm doing just the same thing on different class name and fetching all the details into a different array. Once I do those two things, all I need to do now is basically just, of course, letting ourselves know that we have the right information in place, and we'll run the script in a minute. And then I want to upload it. So look how easy is the API itself. I'm creating a new one. Basically, I already created one, but here I'm just creating or calling the constructor of this object that here it's called spreadsheet. And the debug information is just for us right now. Actually, I see that we have two lines of it, so I need to remove one. Here, of course, you want to put your credentials, probably your Gmail address and then the password. And very important, the sheet name and the worksheet. So both of them need to be here so we know which sheet we are going to update. And then we're calling in the callback after this returning the sheet ready method. And if we'll scroll back to this method, basically you could see that it's very, very simple one. We're adding to the spreadsheet on the top, so it will be at column one, row one, and then column one, row two, the attribute and the value. And then we're just going to iterate and just add those arrays. And luckily for us, any looping here will just call our object, the spreadsheet, and we'll add an array. We're giving it the starting point. And once it gets the starting point, all we need to do is that just attach the array, and all the information will be there. And of course, we're sending all the information in one batch and getting the response. Here, probably you want to notify the user that everything is done correctly and is in the good hands of Google Cloud, so all the data is now saved. And of course, if something wrong happens, just communicate it back. That's all the script. So you could see here that at the bottom, there's nothing more than it. And now we could check, or let me show you how you could quite easily run this script. So let's see again in this window. This is my terminal. I'll make the font even bigger and even one step bigger. And what you could see here is that I'm calling Node with the fetch example that we have here. And once I'm running it, quite quickly, we're going to Google, actually Yahoo API. We're fetching the information. Here, the console log, just making sure, actually, it's from here, that I'm fetching the information. And you could see that in this case, for instance, the key will be the market cap, and then I'm having the raw value of the company, and again, lots of other parameters. And then when I'm wanting to upload it to Google, I got in the login error, and this is because all I have there right now are the to-dos and not my real credentials. But I highly encourage you to fork the gist that we just showed and just put your credentials and work with it and see how fluent it's working. The other beauty is that you could take this code that we ran, and let me just again show with you the snippet itself. We could actually see it here. And this code, with very few changes, will work from Google App, Google Sheets, as well. So if you don't want even to have the ability or the efficiency of running this simple script inside Node, you could do the same from the JavaScript that will run Sheets. And that's another benefit for the ones that doesn't want to work with a Node instance. However, I highly encourage you to check Compute Engine and to check the ability to run with Node.js, because the performances will be much, much better. And if you want to do something more than just putting a simple example like that, you want some heavy lifting on the server side, some data manipulation, some things that you do want a strong server side, Node.js on Compute Engine will give you those benefits, and it's highly recommended to check it out. So if we have any questions, right now is the right time. Let's see here. Let's see if in the chat we have some. I don't see any question right now. So if you have later on any questions, plus GreenyDo on G+, or GreenyDo is one word on Twitter, both will work quite nicely. And happy hacking, and be strong. Bye-bye.